Good morning, I'm Robin Tidwell, Realtor with ERA Newland & Company, here for your Caffeinate and Real Estate Sunday Fix. Have you ever wondered as a seller how you defend yourself in a real estate transaction? Grab a cup, let's talk about it. Let's talk about self-defense in real estate today. I know what you're thinking. Where do I take a good self-defense class? Team Chip, Women's Self-Defense, once a month, and it's free. Check them out. If you're a seller in a real estate transaction, how do you defend yourself from something coming up later and a buyer coming back and trying to sue you over it? The first thing to do is hire a realtor. The second thing to do, grab a really big glass of integrity. Being open and honest throughout the transaction is the best thing that you can do. I know you love your house, but remember it's just a house and things go wrong sometimes and it's okay, but we have to disclose to a future buyer if anything is going on in the house to the best of your knowledge. Sellers do this on a form called a seller's disclosure. It is a way that the sellers can communicate to a potential buyer anything that's going on in the house. This form is tedious and definitely takes some perseverance to get through. And historically, sellers don't like filling it out because they don't want to say what's wrong with their property. They obviously want to shine the best light on the house so that they can get the most money for the house and sell it in the quickest amount of time. However, sellers should remember that giving inadequate or incomplete information on this form could really cause some legal issues. For more information about this topic, and others, go to caffeinateandrealestate.com, and I'll see you next Sunday.